It's called the Scholar's Mate.
How'd you do it?
Not today.
Show me.
Not today.
Okay, so question number one. Which square, which pawn in Black's position is the weakest at the start of the game? Okay, have you all written down your answer? Good. So hopefully if you were paying attention to last week, we said the weakest pawn at the start of the game is the f7 pawn, this one here. And if you're playing white, it would be the f2 pawn. What's the reason? It's the only square that isn't actually defended by the piece. The only piece that is defending this square is the king. And the king, as we know, is not a very good defender. So give yourselves 10 points if you gave that as the correct answer. Okay, we're going to start the game. White plays pawn to e4. And I want you to meet this with e5. This is the move that I recommend. And then we know the theme is Scholar's Mate. There's a couple of ways that white can start here. So we're going to start off with what we called the Patzer move last week. Queen to h5. And now here's the question. How did I tell you to respond to this move? So if you think about what white is doing. So white's getting ready to attack the f7 pawn, but at the same time white is attacking this pawn on e5. So how did I tell you to respond to this move? Have you all written down your answers? Good. So if you remember from last week, those of you that were here, when white plays the queen to h5 on move 2, I wanted you to play knight to c6. So a simple move, developing a piece and defending this pawn on e5. So if you wrote down knight c6, give yourself 10 points. I'll also accept for d6 is another okay move. I don't like it as much as knight c6 because although it is defending the pawn on e5, we're not developing a piece, so for that reason, knight c6, I think, is a stronger move there. No points at all if you played knight f6. That would be a mistake, because although it is attacking the queen, the queen has time to take this pawn with check, and white will be up a pawn, which we don't want. And a really, really bad move would be g6 here. So if you remember, we talked about g6 in some positions last week, but here it's too early. Because don't forget, although we're blocking the diagonal and we're attacking the queen, we've not done anything about attacking this pawn, defending this pawn on e5. And what's worse, because it's even worse than knight f6, we're now going to lose the rook as well because it's a fork. So we've taken the pawn with check, attacking the king, and we're going to lose the rook next move. So that would be a disaster, and you could probably resign the game straight away. So definitely don't do that. Okay, so continuing on from, we've played knight c6 to defend the pawn. And of course, we're looking at Scholar's Mate, so white continues with bishop c4. So critical moment, bishop c4. White, so always think about what your opponent's doing. White is attacking this pawn with the bishop and with the queen. That's twice. Black is defending it once. So if it was white to move here, white could play queen to f7, checkmate. So here's the question. What should black play to stop checkmate? Okay, let's look at this position. So we're being threatened by checkmate. How should we meet the threat? Well, if you think back to last week, the move I suggested was g6. So award yourself 10 points if you selected the g6 move. Why is g6 a good move? Well, if we go back a couple of moves, so do you remember in this position, we talked about g6 being a really bad move. So what's the difference? Well, the difference is in the position in the game, we've already played knight to c6. So here, White can capture the pawn. But if we go on to the position that we're looking at here, with the knight having already been played, defending the pawn, so now we can play g6, and if white was to capture, then of course we would capture the queen. So white's not going to do that. So white has to spend the time moving the queen again. So obviously g6 is blocking the diagonal, so it stopped the checkmate threat because the pawn is in the way on g6. And although it's a pawn move, g6 isn't useless because the bishop would quite like to be on g6, so it is a good developing move for black as well. Black can play bishop g7 next. So 10 points if you've played g6. What other moves could be played? I would also give, let's say, 7 points if you played queen e7. So queen a7 would also defend the f7 pawn. So basically, if we count the... So white is attacking that square twice, but black now would be defending the square twice. So if white was to capture, black would capture, white would capture, black would capture. And if we count the pieces, white would have lost a piece, so black would be winning the game there. So queen a e7 would also be a good defensive move. Queen f6, okay, I suppose would do the same thing. I don't like queen a f6 as much because the knight would really like to be on that square. But take 4 points if you played knight f6. I'm not going to give any points for knight h6. So I suppose knight h6 does defend the f7 square. So it would mean that we are stopping checkmate. However, I think we're going to get into trouble. So if white plays a move like d3, so you can see the white bishop is opened up and it's threatening to take the knight. And if the knight is away, then checkmate could easily follow. And it's not a natural square for the knight to be on h6. So I don't like the knight to h6 move. I think g6 is or queen e7 are much stronger moves. So g6 for 10 points, queen e7 for 7 points, queen f6 for 4 points. I'm not going to give points for anything else. Okay, so let's go back to g6, which we've just played. So it's white to move in this position. And if your opponent's played like this, there's every chance that they will want to continue the attack. So we've blocked them off from the f7 square. So what's white going to do? He's going to want to still try and checkmate you, aren't they, really? So queen to f6, I would imagine there's every chance. So white now, if you think about what your opponent's just done. So we're renewing the threat. So the queen is now once again hitting the f7 pawn. The bishop is attacking the f7 pawn. So we're once again being threatened by checkmate. The g6 move, although it's a good move, hasn't stopped this particular threat. So what should we do? What should white play? What move would you suggest? Have a look at the position. Write down what you think is the next move. We're going to pause the video. Have you all written down what you would play in this position? Good. Okay, so if you think back to last week, the move I told you to play here was knight f6. Again, another natural developing move. So knight f6. The white cannot take the knight because it's protected by the queen. So it's very, very, very safe. And what's more, the knight is blocking the checkmate. So white was attacking f7 with the queen and the bishop, but because we've put the knight in the way this time, it's blocked white's checkmate threat. And so take 10 points if you played knight f6. I think that's definitely the best move. Another similarly good move is queen e7. So again, we're just spending a move to defend the pawn. And we're not as bothered about blocking the bishop from this diagonal now because we've already made a little nest for our bishop on g7. So the bishop's happy to come to g7 next turn. So that would also be a good move, I would say. So take 8 points if you played queen to e7. Queen to f6, I suppose you could play. You're blocking again the checkmate threat with your queen. And then if white wants to trade the queens, we could play queen, knight takes queen. And I'd rather not trade the queens this early, personally. But it would be a reasonable enough position. If white doesn't trade the queens, though, here, perhaps you could say the knight really would have wanted to go on that square. So I think queen f6 probably isn't quite as good a move, but it does stop checkmate. So take 6 points if you played queen to f6. I don't think I'm going to award... Sorry, just get back to the position. I don't think I'm going to award points for anything else. Obviously, don't play a move like Beth played in the game, because that would just allow checkmate. So we need whatever we play needs to stop this checkmate threat. I suppose the only other move that really stops checkmate is knight h6, which does defend the pawn, but I don't like that move again. It's not a natural square for the knight. If we talk about white might just be playing d3 next, and white's threat now will be to exchange the bishop for the knight. And then after bishop takes bishop, it's going to be checkmate again. So I don't like the move knight h6, even though it stops checkmate for one turn, so I'm not going to give a point for that one. Okay, so we left the position after black has just played the knight to f6. And to be honest with you, I think at this point we can say from this particular line, black is fine. Black, this is kind of the end of the opening. If we look on the right-hand side, I've brought up some analysis of games that have been played from this position. Personally, I think the only plan that could really bother you for black here is if white tries to maybe play bishop to b5, followed by the knight to c3, knight to d5, and try and exploit the pin. But again, it's nothing to worry about. So let's see a couple of the games that have been played. So the most played move here is knight e2, but let's say white plays a move like d3. So let's see what black has done here. Well, knight to d4 straight away is a perfectly good move. We can see from the statistics here, the evaluation is that what black already has a small advantage. I mean, let's say we just continue to play naturally. Bishop to g7. I don't see anything wrong with this. Knight c3. So again, he's going for this knight e5 square. Castles. Bishop to g5. So this is the only line that I'd say is a little bit threatening, because knight to d5 might be threatening. But I think here we can probably play something like knight to d4. Attacking the queen, and the queen's no longer going to be able to sustain its threat on the knight. And then once the queen moves away to defend this pawn, maybe a move like c6 here to stop the knight coming in. And black is perfectly comfortable. Black is probably a bit better in this position. So after just 9 moves, white has got no advantage and black is happy. Okay, so we're going to leave the analysis here. So this was the line where white brought the queen out to h5 on move 2. And which is probably the most dangerous line. I'm just going to, if white uses any other move order, so if you saw in the video, white played on move 2, bishop to c4, which is another way of attacking this pawn. And you know what white's plan is. Obviously, they can go a different way, but if white wants to go for the scholar's mate, they're going to follow it up with either queen to f3 or queen to h5. But in this move order, black can put a stop to scholar's mate straight away with a move. So this is if the bishop comes out first, not the queen, because if the queen came out first, you couldn't do this. But just take a look at this position. After bishop c4, what would you play for black? And I'm only going to accept the move that we talked about last week. Okay, so the final position we're going to look at today. So instead of queen h5 on move 2, we're saying if white starts with bishop c4, well, in this position, why not just bring the knight out straight away, knight to f6, an excellent move, developing the knight, attacking the pawn on e4. But the point is that white now cannot, if you look at the squares that this knight controls, the knight is controlling the h5 square, so the queen cannot come to that square or she will be captured. Similarly, if the queen comes to f3, well, that would be a pointless move because the knight is already stationed on f6, which is stopping the queen accessing the f7 square, so there's no longer a checkmate threat. So you could, so you don't even need to react to the queen f3. You could just continue with your development, knight to c6, and you can probably just carry on with your game, get castled early, and you can have a comfortable position. And this knight is saying, what are you doing on my square? I wanted to be on that square. So this is why Scholar's Mate isn't such a great opening. It's never, if you don't win the game in the first few moves, if black defends successfully, you've just really brought out the queen too early. So if in this position you played knight f6, give yourself a final 10 points. So I'm going to round that off now. So add up your points. There were 5 questions in total that we asked you. Did anyone get 50 points? If you did, very, very well done. Any of you that didn't, maybe have a look over. We'll maybe put this video up on the Facebook page, and you can go over it in your own time. What I'd like you to do now is, if you'd like to split up into pairs, and I want one of you to play the white pieces and go for Scholar's Mate, and I want the black player to defend it using some of the techniques that we've just learnt. And then when you finish that game, if you've got time, maybe swap the colours round and the other person play white and go for Scholar's Mate and see if the black player can defend. Just to emphasise, I don't particularly recommend playing this for white in your games. The reason we're showing you these videos is how to defend against it, because I'm pretty sure that when we come to the tournament, you're going to face players who will try this against you. So it's really important that you know what to do. All right, and I'll see you next week.